Halloween was Monday, which also marked the start of the Mexican holiday, Day of the Dead, which wraps up today. What better way to commemorate it than by exploring what happens in nature after something dies? Naturalist Curtis Parsons joins us to show us the mysterious world of decomposers. Curtis, what are decomposers? This is new to me.
So decomposers, they play a really, really important role in ecosystems. So what they do is they take dead or decaying matter and they kind of speed up the process.
So why is that so important?
Well, if we didn't have decomposers, then there'd be a lot of dead animals, dead plants, especially leaves. You know, leaves fall in the fall time. They just litter the ecosystems. It'd be everywhere.
And a lot of stench, too.
It would not smell great.
What did you bring with me? A little display here of decomposers?
Yeah, so I've brought a couple different things. Obviously, a lot of people, you know, when they think of something dead and dying, maggots on it. Those come from flies, typically. So I've got some flies in here. Some also really cool ones, the top there, those are American carrion beetles. So they're attracted to dead flesh, they eat that.
Wow.
And these are also called burying beetles. They also focus in on decaying matter. And then the other ones, they kind of vary. They might focus in on plants, but they also focus on animals as
well. So what are some of the Missouri decomposers? Are these all Missouri decomposers or no?
Yeah, all these that I have here that are pinned, these, you can find all these here in Missouri. That's a pretty good variety that I could come up with.
Now, someone that wants to follow in your footsteps finds this very curious. Would this fall under entomology or zoology? What courses would you have to take?
If you want to focus in on the insects, then yes, entomology is a great course to take. You're going to learn a lot of this stuff. And there's actually a field called forensic entomology that they focus on the bugs that do the decaying.
Awesome. And what makes a burying beetle so unique?
So burying beetles are really amazing insects.
And which one is that here? Is that?
So we've got three of them right here.
All right.
That are pinned. We also have a federally endangered one that has been released in Missouri called the American burying beetle. They're really amazing because a male and a female will find a dead animal, drag it to a spot they really like. They bury it underground, hence the name burying beetle.
Right.
They go underground with it. The female lays her eggs on it. And then this is the really creepy part. When the eggs hatch, the parents will actually work together and feed the dead animal carcass to the babies.
No way. That's awesome.
So, and so, you know, obviously that's kind of creepy, kind of weird.
Right.
But it's also really unique to an insect because most insects don't care for their young.
Yeah, creepy started with these. Your story is borderline real creepy.
Yeah.
Well, Curtis Parsons of the Missouri Department of Conservation website, quickly.
MDC.mo.gov.
Very good. And you could visit KPLR or download our app, KPLR11.com. Coming up.